Hi everyone, this is a viewer's topics request. We talk about the colouring fertilizer. In recent years, we have wide spectrums of colours available in the Malaysian market. Big companies such as Yara, Bemeyer, and even small company manufacturers make use of colouring agent to coat the fertilizers. Some say it's a marketing strategy that helps to attract farmers' attention, or rebrand themselves from the counterpart manufacturers. But here comes the problem. Will that actually pose any side effects on us as an end user who consume those crops which being fed with artificial light color fertilizers? And now we are going to dive more about these issues. There are a few things you need to know about color fertilizers and in-depth understanding of what it can do and what it can affect us as an end users. First of all, compound fertilizer happens to be colorless. Even experienced farmers and sellers couldn't tell the exact type of fertilizer without looking at the label or on the plastic sack. This might lead to confusion to sellers that are afraid of selling wrong product to their customers. Secondly, without colours, farmers couldn't tell the exact concentration that has been diluted. They might face difficulties in controlling quantity of fertilizer used without the shade of colour. And this is why colours plays an important role in coping these two problems. In order to make sure colours are not duplicate to one another, they created a wide spectrum of colours so they are able to designate respective fertilizer formula. And that brings us to point 2. Each colour represents its functionality and its nature. There are some rules of thumb that you can quickly scan through with eyeballs by the look of the colour. Normally, the green one usually for plants growth such as 15-15, 16-16 or 20-10-10. The red one usually for fruiting such as 13-13-21, 13-10-20. And the blue one usually for flowering and fruiting such as 12-12-17. Lastly, for orange one usually for flowering such as 15-9-20 and 15-5-20. But sometimes there are always room for exception. Such as Bemeyer 15-15-15, it exists in orange in color. Yara 16-16-16 appear to be blue. And another one, Yara 12-12-17-2, actually happens to be white in color. And of course, there are still other examples that exist in different colors. Therefore, as a buyer, if you really can't differentiate the color of the fertilizer, and you should have always consult the sellers for confirmation to be make sure that you don't buy the wrong fertilizer. And here comes another question. Does the color density and the structure always correlate with this quality? In the market, you realize there are two types of fertilizer. One is a little bit mushy and dull in color, and the one is bright and is rigid in structure. And these two factors actually affect the quality of the fertilizer. And obviously, a bright and clean fertilizer is better than the dull and mushy ones. According to the manufacturer, they need to observe fertilizer appearances, whether the mixing effect of trace elements and other nutrients are in ideal state. And also, perfectly coated fertilizer helps to avoid nutrient degenerated from time exposed to the air. And so it helps to ensure high quality fertilizer for a long period of time. And here comes the core topic. Will the colouring agents affect our health directly or indirectly? But before that, we're going to go in a little bit more detail. In the market, there are actually organic or inorganic pigments. Organic pigments usually derive from food source. On the other hand, the inorganic pigments usually extracted from earth metals. The most common ones are iron oxide, carbon black, and also some other colored trace elements such as manganese sulfate, copper sulfate, etc. So the real question is, are those two color sources actually affects our health? According to the food standard rule, the colouring allowable for food dressing is roughly around 0.5% based on the colour used to food mass proportion. Surprisingly, the colouring pigment used in granular fertiliser is much lower than 0.001%, and even the highest is only about 1% on water-soluble fertiliser. And that which means the food and drinks that we consume daily, the colouring agent used is more than the fertilisers. This is such a mind-blowing fact that no one actually expected that. And for the inorganic matters, such as ferrum oxide being used commonly, does that actually pollute our environment and our health? According to the study, it is part of the natural mineral and it's not a heavy metal. So basically, it is non-toxic to environment and also to living things that contacted it directly or indirectly. So basically, it's harmless to humans if contacted directly. But just to make sure, stay out of children, as they might mistook them as candy. For the current technologies, the manufacturer trying to improve the quality from time to time. They might get creative playing around with colors, but they still have to make sure it is safe and do not cause any residual effect to the end users. It is understandable to afraid the colors that might affect our health, but under strict rule regulation from governments and giving strict surveillance on those manufacturers have to make sure they are on the right track. So don't worry and keep on gardening. That's all for today. I'll see you on the next video.